Pelvic organ prolapse is caused by the loss of muscle tone and connective tissue support to the pelvic floor organs. We don't always know what causes this condition. For many women, we believe that the initial cause is having a baby. But we know that having a baby alone is not the sole cause of pelvic organ prolapse. There are things that contribute over time. And this has to do with the progressive loss of muscle tone that can occur for all of us as we age, and progressive stretching of the tissue. A lifetime of heavy lifting, chronic straining with constipation, or a chronic cough can all contribute to progressive loss of muscle tone or loss of connective tissue support. There are many surgical options available in the treatment of pelvic organ prolapse. They're broadly broken down into two categories, either done through the vagina or through the abdomen. But when we operate through the abdomen, that's usually in a minimally invasive way, using laparoscopy. And we're doing many of our cases now at OHSU using the surgical robot. Non-surgical treatments for pelvic organ prolapse revolve around either strengthening your own muscle tone by doing Kegel exercises or the use of a device called a pessary. Properly fitted in place, you don't even know it's there, but the symptoms of the prolapse are relieved because now the organs are elevated. I would encourage women to talk to their doctors if they're concerned that they're starting to develop pelvic organ prolapse. The reason for this is that there are several conservative options that are available to catch prolapse as it's starting, so hopefully we can stop the progression over time. It's a problem that many women experience, so don't be fearful to talk to your doctor about this problem. I'm sure they've heard it before, and it's important to be able to offer you treatment options. What I love most about my job is allowing women to gain some control over a quality of life condition that can really impact their ability to feel good about themselves, to be social, and to be active. Many women with incontinence or prolapse describe a feeling of isolation, like they're fearful of going out, they may be fearful of being intimate, and by helping them with this condition, it just helps them feel better about themselves, improves their quality of life, and takes away some of those fears.